Today, I'm excited to share with you a brand new device that'll allow you to edit with your team remotely as if you were in the same room. Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to Gal. Today, I'm talking about remote editing workflows and efficiency. So video editing from home, if you need to share files with multiple people on a team, is not easy. Using VPNs and cloud storage is painfully slow. You have to upload, re-download, and I recently experienced that with my editing intern, Vanessa, who I onboarded a couple months ago. She is based in Dallas, and I'm here in Europe in Warsaw, Poland, and I had to share all the files with her project file. She had to download it, and all of the media was offline. She had to reconnect it, and then once she was done, she had to reshare everything. It didn't seem that efficient, and I feel like some of you guys have experienced that workflow. During this time especially, it's important for us to have the ability to work efficiently and share files efficiently. But cloud storage isn't it. So what exactly can we use to edit at the same speed as what we could have in a studio office where everybody was there together? How can we achieve that same speed as if Vanessa was in the same room as me, even though we're thousands of miles apart? So this is why I was super excited when ProMAX reached out to me and they're like, hey, we have a new device that will solve this for you so you don't have to do that re-uploading. The files will just be there and you'll have the same path. And I was like, what? How is this possible? This is awesome. I gotta get my hands on it. So basically this video is showing you how this ProMAX Mediahub works, how to set it up, and sort of a review of what I think about it and how I use it with Premiere Pro production files. So let's go ahead and jump on in. First, let's start with the tech specs. The Mediahub is a brand new piece of hardware and it's 4 inches by 2 inches in a black box. It actually fits in the palm of my hand and it's so much smaller than any other shared device I've used before. I've had giant ones before and this one I was really surprised when it arrived to learn how small it was. Under the hood, it has its own CPU, an Intel Core i3-10U, and the CPU here inside of it is used to set up and operate the ProMAX platform server software. And in terms of storage for all of your video project files, it has options of 2 terabytes, 4 terabytes, or 8 terabytes of solid state drive storage. On the front of the ProMAX Mediahub, you'll see that there is a power on button on the right. Next to that, there's an output for sound. And to the left, there is a USB-C port and a USB 3.1 generation 2. On the side, if we move it, you'll find a convenient SD card slot for importing footage. And on the back, you'll find the power supply, an HDMI port, which is really only used during setup to be able to connect the Mediahub's computer to a monitor for setup purposes. Then there's an Ethernet port to connect it to your computer, and there are 2 additional USB 3.1 Generation 2 USB ports and a Thunderbolt 3 port. The Thunderbolt and USB options enable you to hook up other storage devices to the hub, but it's completely optional. The Mediahub connects to your computer using Wi-Fi or using an Ethernet cable. It's recommended to connect it via Ethernet as it's faster and more stable for editing. If you're using a MacBook Pro, which only has USB-C ports, you can get an adapter like I have so you can hook up the Ethernet directly to your computer. And every team member that you're working with needs to have the Mediahub in their home office. So whether they're in the same city or in different countries, you need to have the device to be able to share the same files. So the way it worked is that ProMAX sent me the Mediahub. So I received it. They sent one to Vanessa in Dallas, Texas. And then we had a setup call with Brian, their awesome tech guru. And we basically had a Zoom call where he remoted in and was able to make sure everything was set up correctly. So what he did was set up a peer-to-peer network where my Mediahub was a sync of Vanessa's and vice versa. So they're exactly the same file path. We were able to see the exact same things and we're thousands of miles apart. Vanessa's in Dallas, I'm here in Warsaw, Poland. It's amazing that we're able to do this. So once that was all set up, we were able to log into the ProMAX platform via a web browser. And once logged in, you could see what ProMAX syncs you have available. So Brian set up four for us, but of course, ProMax can customize this to your needs and change the titles of them, etc. To mount one of these syncs, just click on dismount here and it will change the status to mounted. One of the things that Brian did was set up the software on the computer. So there's an icon now on my desktop called the ProMax platform. And if I double click on that, I will see any mounted devices on my computer. And if I just dragged in a file, immediately within 10 seconds, Vanessa would see that file in the same path, which is super cool. So the syncing of the files happens in real time, which is something you can't really get with VPNs or cloud storage. But one thing to consider is that if another person on your team has a slow internet connection, if they upload a large file, other files that you try to upload can get stuck behind it. So one way to get around that is to mount one of the other syncs and upload that file to that other sync so it doesn't get caught in the other syncs. So that's one workaround you can do if you find that the files are lagging when you're trying to upload them. So at this point, you might ask, how is it different from cloud storage? First, let's start with a comparison of existing workflows. What I did was when I finished a shoot, I had 80 gigabytes of footage, let's say, and I uploaded it to Dropbox for Vanessa. Once it was done, depending on the internet connection, it could take anywhere from 30 minutes to 2 hours. I sent her a message, hey, everything's up there, it should be synced. She finally downloaded it. And then after the download was done, let's say another 2 hours, she was able to start editing. So now with the Media Hub, I have the same 80 gigabytes of footage. I import it into my computer. I simply drag all those files into my Media Hub sync. Then once it's done, however long it takes, the same amount of time because internet speed is the same, I ping Vanessa and I say, hey, it's available. When she gets home, she opens up her laptop. She doesn't have to download. It's already synced and on her Media Hub. So that's the key difference. There's no downloading from the cloud. It's already on Vanessa's Media Hub. So Vanessa and I have been using the sync for the last couple of projects. So what I'm gonna do is just jump in and show you my folder structure and how I organize it and open up a Premiere Pro production to show you how it works. Here you can see that on my Media Hub within our shared space, I have a folder for production files. Then I have a media folder. And here I put all of the camera video files, audio, images, screen recordings, motion graphics, and there's a folder for each type of media type. And then I have an output folder, and this is where I have all the exported and final videos and a few more folders for various other files. And the best way to start editing, whether it's Vanessa or I opening up a file, is to start in Premiere Pro. So once Premiere Pro is open, I go to File, Open Production, because I've already created a production. And then I select my production folder, which is the 2020 GAL tutorials. By the way, if you're not seeing the ability to create a production or open a production in Premiere, it's because you need to update to the latest version. So this will open up a production panel, and from here you can double click to open a project. And if there's another person editing one of these Premiere projects, it'll show that it's locked by that editor. So once you open up a project, it'll have a green pen icon next to the project that you're editing. And if you want to start a new Premiere Pro project in this production panel, you can click on the new project icon and then give it a name. Now, the best part about this production panel is that it's a mirror copy of what's in the production folder on my Media Hub. So if I add in more folders here or a new project in the production panel, it will add the new folders and projects to the folder structure on the Media Hub, so it's a mirrored copy. In each Premiere Pro project that is open, whether Vanessa has it open or I do, all of the media points to the same media folder on our Media Hub, so none of the files go offline. And of course, you don't need to use the Premiere Pro Productions feature to use the ProMax Media Hub. You can definitely use individual project files or any type of file. I just prefer to use the new production architecture because it just works better for the larger tutorial projects I'm working on. And yeah, it's worked really great so far. There's only been one sync issue, but I literally reached out to the ProMax team right away, and then we were on a call together and we were able to resolve it. It was just simply resetting the device. So that's how I use MediaHub in my current workflow, and it's working great. And if you think that the solution might work for you or your team, I encourage you to check out the link below that includes information on how to contact ProMAX to get your team set up. And if you mention Premier Gal, you can get 20% off the software, not the hardware though. So thank you, ProMAX, for getting the Gal team set up, and I hope to expand out more so we can have more team members around the world collaborating. And now let's go to the comment of the week. This week's comment of the week was from FiscoDisco. He commented on my how to live stream with a DSLR camera video, and he wrote, "Do you need a cam link or can you use a mini HDMI to USB cable?" Now, this is for live streaming. And actually, Canon, I believe when pandemia hit, they created a free software so you can actually connect your Canon camera via USB to stream, and it will capture the video input onto your computer. Now, I haven't tried this out, but if you have a Canon camera, you can try this. But if you don't have a Canon, I do believe you still need to get Cam Link or another type of capture card to be able to take the video signal from your camera and hook it up to your laptop. So go check out that video if you're interested in learning about capture cards. And yeah, that's all for this video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.